people, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Sir P. Now, it's only been 2 days into December, and already a bit of foolishness are going on at the place, people. Now, after hearing reports that the DJ named Sicker Rhymes got ambushed up there near Sovereign, I immediately started to think this is going to be a spooky December. Because knowing who Sicker Rhymes is, who him link with, where he's from, I know them on the roll, I was thinking, boy, there's going to be problems. But I didn't realize it would be of this magnitude. Now, before I go any further, let me just tell the people, for those who don't know, who Sicker Rhymes is. Now, as I said, he's a DJ, right? But that's probably not why you're interested in this matter, because I don't think most people know a single Sicker Rhymes song, right? But the what's causing the whole fuss is that he's actually the cousin of dancehall artist Aditya Palmer, more popularly known as Vybz Kartel, right? Now, as I said, he's related to Kartel, but he's not a Palmer. His last name is actually Chambers, right? And as I said, he come from out of the Waterford. Now, Sicker Rhymes was coming from a party, right? And the man named ambush him, right? Wet him up a couple of times, but they didn't finish him off, right? You know these things go already. Usually 87 is just spray off a couple rounds and then speed off. Yeah, even though it was like after 3 a.m. and they had all the time in the world for do what they might do. But usually the man them will go carry out these missions, they're so nervous and jittery that them can't wait for get away. Right? Now, after Sicker Rhymes was in the hospital, buckling for his life, I was thinking to myself, well, we're gonna start here about a one shooting here and a one shooting there. People, I know I didn't realize just how serious the man in the dog go feed. Now you might have heard that there was a triple murder in Waterford, right? Yes, 3 people drop out one time. And not only that, right? It was actually 3 people from one family. Oh, and it gets even more interesting. It's actually 3 generation of people drop out one time. You might be thinking to yourself, come again, explain Sir P, what do you mean 3 generation? People, the man named licked down the granny, 74-year-old Pamela Russell. That's 1 generation. The man named licked down our daughter, 48-year-old Shamelia Russell. Right? And the 3rd generation was their 21-year-old grandson called Romario Craig. 3 generation, 3 people, 1 go. Now, you might be thinking, well, what could Granny have to do with what happened to Sicker Rhymes, right? Obviously, Granny wasn't out there in a 3 o'clock a morning, a pull-off, no shooting. People, it turns out the man them come for a youth were related to these people, right? He was blamed for the attack on Sicker Rhymes, and the man them decided they were going to go for him to, I guess, deal with him case. When they went there, he wasn't present, right? Now, after realizing that them target wasn't in the house, you know that old time saying, if you can't catch Quarko, you catch him short. Well, the man didn't just catch him short, the man didn't catch him jeans, him underpants, all him shoes, right? Because 3 people end up losing them life over foolishness. Complete foolishness. Now, to me, and I'm hoping most of my viewers and subscribers, the idea that you come for your man, and in the day, so you take out granny, granny daughter, and grandson, makes no sense. But in the world of 87s, that is completely logical. According to the 87 handbook, that is justified. Right? Now, when the news came out, I also heard that the daughter, Shamelia Russell, she's actually a teacher at Vars Prep. So the whole staff and students at Vars Prep apparently were traumatized, right, and had to be getting grief counseling because, of course, one of their teachers, who I'd imagine is very beloved down there, right, has get taken out in extremely tragic circumstances. I mean, it's one thing when you are by the road and something happened to you. See, this is the thing, you know, people. When you know somebody bad, and then you hear something happened to them, in the back of your mind, you're thinking, well, it was all them at that time, right? Or you're thinking, well, karma finally catch up on him. But when somebody's a teacher, I mind them own business, but just so happen to be related to somebody who I keep up them foolishness in other place, and then they end up losing their life for something that person did, people, it's extra tragic. Extra tragic, right? And things get even spookier because these three people are related to a current member of the Jamaica Labour Party, right? A politician for the Waterford Division, a man by the name of Krisha Holmes, right? So this thing is going to get out of hand, right? Not only from a street level, because obviously the youth of them come for and then they catch him. Now that's them take out three members of the Fim family, right? Obviously, him have blood in a Fim eye, right? So there's no telling what he's going to do, right? Or what him and Fim friend them are going to do in retaliation, right? And then to make things worse, because a politician's people them, you know how that go already, right? So the whole community of Waterford is now completely tense. Right, everybody upon them guard, and Waterford has had a troubled history. Right, I remember Waterford way back in the days when the community was split in two. Right, for those of you who really, really know Waterford that around them time there, back then there were two sides. There was Adi Bantan on one side, right, and a DJ named Mikey Pelper on the other side. Right, and people who really know the most people know Vibes Cartel as Vibes Cartel, but Waterford people know Adi Bantan, right? And from those days, Waterford did hot. And I remember the infamous peace march between Mikey Pelper and Cartel, when police did pressure the two of them and make them have to walk through Waterford and, you know, declare peace and say, boy, everybody good and re and all kind of politics, right? Mikey Pelper did end up drop out. I think he might try to smuggle go firing on Joan, right? And obviously, Adi Bantan in a jail, right? But Waterford has always had a troubled past, back and forth. But it's been a while since anything gone over there, right? The place has actually been running kind of smooth by their standards, right? But now that this extraordinary act has happened, people, Waterford have got hot because, as I said, it now got done. Right, you're not going to just take out three people out of somebody's family and them say, well, you know, these things happen, it's time for us to move on. That's just not how it works. And as I said, what makes things extra terrible is that innocent people are getting taken out for it. Right, and Sika Rhymes is actually the person who you could say is probably one of the closest people to Vibes Cartel as he's in jail, because he plays the role of almost like a facilitator, right? He's the one that go back and forth, go link Cartel at jail and go. So for example, if you want to get a dub from Cartel, or you want to deliver a message, or you want to send something to game, Sika Rhymes is the person who you would go to, and him would facilitate all of this, right? So he's very, very close to Vibes Cartel. Very, very close, right? And of course, the usual people on social media have started ball theme already. Sean Storm, who is currently serving time with Cartel, right? Lisa Hyper, right? Apparently, she went to go visit him in the jail, and she went to go visit Sika Rhymes in the hospital. And according to her, the reason why this happened to him is because she's saying it's just bad mind. People see my rise, and people don't like that. I mean, if you believe somebody left Waterford, go all the way up a sovereign, just call them the likes, Sika Rhymes rise. I mean, hey, unicorn still a sell, right? They can't run out a unicorn, we have them. So, people, we have to just listen out of here what's going to come out of this. Because, as I said, I would not like to be a resident in Waterford right now. If anybody live at Waterford, right now and them have any other place they can go cool out for the December, please just pack up on the things and take a break from Waterford right now, because the whole place will get spooky. Very spooky. And if you notice, Cartel has been silent online. Considering how close him and Sicker Rhymes is, Vybz Kartel has been very silent, especially on this matter, since him cousin get wet up. That is on purpose. People, keep an eye on the case. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Please like, comment, and share the video as usual. Bless.